That verse of the Quran where Allah says, when a calamity strikes, you are supposed to declare your closeness to Allah and confirm that you are going to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember that. So that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us. When a problem happens, it's not the end of the world. But even if it was the end of the world, who would you return to? To Allah. So you say, inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Nothing can be bad for a mu'min. There is another way that the Prophet ﷺ has taught us to react. You know, Abu Sufyan, before he was a Muslim, he was the leader of the Meccans, the Meccan army. And prior to him being a leader, he was one of the top leaders. But after the death of Abu Jahl, etc., he became the leader. He prepared an army to come back to attack Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the Meccans had sent a huge army to come and attack, and the mu'mineen were small in number, 313, small number. They were not even prepared with their own weapons. And what happened? The army had come forth and they were coming. Someone got to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and told him that Abu Sufyan and them are coming. And this is the condition upon which they are coming, which means they're heavily armed. You know what? Allah mentions this in the Quran.
الَّذِينَ قَالَ لَهُمُ النَّاسُ إِنَّ النَّاسَ قَدْ جَمَعُوا لَكُمْ فَاخْشَوْهُمْ فَزَادَهُمْ إِيمَانًا وَقَالُوا حَسْبُنَا اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ.
Allah says, you remember the time when the people came to the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam and told him that those people are coming. Those people are coming. You need to be scared of them. You need to fear them. You need to watch out for them. And what did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam do? What happened to the true believers? Allah says, it increased their conviction. It made them firm in their faith. And they said, Hasbunallah wa ni'mal wakil. Allah is sufficient for us, and He is the best disposer of our affairs. My brothers, my sisters, when Allah closes a door for you, and a second door, and a third door, and a fourth door, it is because the fifth door will lead you to a place way beyond the first four doors. You have to be convinced. You tried something, Allah closed the door, you came out again. You tried something, Allah closed the second door and the third. Whether it was a marriage and you ended up divorced once, twice, thrice. Some of the brothers and sisters, especially the sisters who've been divorced more than twice, they will tell you, I've given up. Now I'm not going to marry. Why? Perhaps the next man or the one after the next man will be such a lovely person that you'll forget about the other five characters that you were married to. Yes. But if you stop, that's where everything stops. You gave up, that's where your hope stops. You lost a job, a second one, a third. You applied one, they didn't accept it, they rejected it. One, two, three, four, five. I applied for 10 jobs. No one's giving me a job because Allah says, you know what? The 12th one is actually a mega, mega deal. Subhanallah. That's why we don't want you to get these 10. But after five, you're giving up. What's happening? You are doing something wrong. Don't react in that way. A reaction of giving up hope is not part of the dictionary of a mu'min. A believer does not give up hope. When something happens, you suffered a loss today, a loss tomorrow. 1 year, business is not going right. 2 years, something is going wrong. For as long as you did not give up hope and you keep thanking Allah and you keep trying, trust me, 5 years later, that multi-million dollar deal that people were waiting, notice I said dollars, not rands, that people were waiting for, subhanallah, came to you. But what happened the 5 years? You struggled. Suddenly you shot up to the top. That was Allah. Why? You reacted with hope. In the face of that, which would have brought about hopelessness to those who don't believe. Allahu Akbar. Hasbunallah wa ni'mal wakil. Allah is sufficient for me, for us. And He is the best disposer of our affairs. Allah says, the verse after that, what a beautiful verse. فَانْقَلَبُوا Allahu Akbar. Allah says, as a result of that conviction that they had and the dua that they made, حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ, we actually converted for them whatever there was in terms of fear that they may have been or may have been warned about into a beautiful coolness, a calmness, success and victory. How did victory come? They reacted correctly.
What is the strategy for believers to become the strongest human beings in this dunya? Strongest in anything that we do. Tell me one thing that we can do to become the strongest of all. And there is no other advice except to have pure tawakkul on the one who is the strongest of all, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He who has Allah has everything. He who does not have Allah has nothing. If you have the dunya and you have every sort of means in this dunya, then you have nothing because the dunya is weak. But if you have Allah, then you have the strongest being on your team and you will eventually win. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whenever a musibah befalls you, if you put your musibah upon mankind to solve it for you, then you will surely lose. And if you put your musibah upon Allah, al-hayy alladhi la yamut, the one who is ever living, the one who will never die, then it is only a matter of time before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings his help down. Ajilan aw ajil, meaning right now or just a little bit later. And he will bring it down and he will help. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered all his anbiya, those of his best friends, he ordered the mu'mineen, and he ordered the sadiqeen, all of them, to be truthful in their tawakkul on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And tawakkul is not the quality of a weak human being. Tawakkul is not the quality of a person who doesn't know what to do. Tawakkul is the bed and breakfast. It is the building blocks of every believer. Yaqulu ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, half of Islam is tawakkul on Allah. 50% of the deen is relying on Allah Azza wa Jal. Why is it? Because Islam tells you to do things which are unbelievable. Islam told the Sahaba to go and fight Persia. Islam told Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to send letters of Islam to the leaders of this world. Islam told Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to go out and to call the Quraysh, who were the Jabbareen on this earth, who were in power and in seats of authority on this earth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always tells the believers to take on a bigger challenge than they can face, than their preparations are. 318 Muslim soldiers taking on 1,000 army of the Quraysh. 3,000 Muslim soldiers taking on 250,000 of the Romans. 130,000 Muslim soldiers taking on the greatest army the world has ever seen, the Persian army. All of this because this is what Islam demands, that you take on a challenge larger than you can bear. And the only way you can win is to have tawakkul on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yaqulu ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, he said, man sarrahu an yakuna aqwa an-nas, whoever wants to be the strongest of people, falyatawakkal 'ala al-hayy alladhi la yamut, then let him put tawakkul on Allah, the one who is ever living, will never die. And this is the essence of strength. The essence of a believer's strength is that not because he has wealth and strength and power and ability, the fact that he has on his side his connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who is able to do all things. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى الْحَيِّ الَّذِي لَا يَمُوتُ وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ وَكِيلًا, and enough is Allah as a wakil for you. أَلَيْسَ اللَّهُ بِكَافٍ عَبْدًا, is Allah not enough for his slave? Is Allah enough, not enough for his slave? And this is why يَقُولُ الشَّافِعِ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهُ, when you see people leaving you and people deserting you, know that this is Allah telling you that Allah is enough for you. Allah is enough for you. Don't you even worry about anyone being on your side. No one supporting you, no one giving you money, no one helping you. Allah is enough for you. So tawakkul on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the greatest quality of any believer who wants to be strong. And it is for this reason why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the Sahaba go and do unbelievable things, because they knew on their side, playing on their side, was the greatest being of all, and that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is why, my brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala helps with his help those people who are sadiq and truthful in their tawakkul Allah. My brothers and sisters in Islam, whatever we do is weak. Our knowledge, our wealth, our sabab, our taking or tying the camel is weak. What? A beggar or a robber at the depths of the night can't come and untie the camel? or the wind could blow and then something could untie the camel? Couldn't the camel move and then untie its own rope? Of course it can. But tying the camel is a weak sabab, and that's the whole point about all of the deeds that we do. They are weak, they are weak. 318 soldiers against 1,000, weak. 3,000 against 250, weak, weak, weak. But we are ordered to do the weak. We are ordered to do the weak because Allah wishes to hide himself in this dunya. And he wishes to test us. Otherwise he would do it for us and there would be no test. It is for this reason why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Ayyub alayhi salatu wasalam, when he complained about him being in sickness, what did he say to Ayyub? And wa idh nada Ayyub, remember when Ayyub called out to Allah, inni massaniya shaytanu bi dhurri wa adhab, verily shaytan has touched me with dhur, with hardship and harm on my body, and adab and punishment. Ayyub, a prophet of God, as some scholars said, he had 15 kids that died on the same day, breakfast, the sun fell, the roof fell down on them and they all died. At that same night, a fire came from the sky and destroyed all his crops. And he had leprosy that started on his body. Ayyub alayhi salam was afflicted by people. People said, Ayyub did some sin. That's why Allah has given him adab and punishment. So for years, Ayyub was thrown out of the city. He lived in a cave. All of this until he made that dua. He said, oh Allah, I have been touched by shaitan. I have been touched by shaitan with hardship on my body, oh Allah. So what did Allah say? Allah says, Urkud bi rijlika hadha mughtasalun sharibun wa bara mughtasalun baridun wa sharab. What does Allah say? Allah said, with your legs hit on the ground. Now imagine a man with leprosy. Imagine a man who's afflicted with sickness. Imagine a man who is lying on the ground, not even standing. Then Allah says to hit the ground with your leg. Would that be enough to break the ground? Would that be enough to crack the ground and cause water to come out? No. But this is what Allah told him to do. Hit with your leg on the ground, a spring will burst forth from which you will be washed and you will then drink from. So this is the essence. This is the essence of what tawakkul is all about. Do the small weak sabab and Allah will do the rest for you. And it is for this reason why Maryam was told the same thing. Maryam, a virgin girl, not been touched by a man, never experienced pleasure with a man. She is now pregnant with a baby in her tummy, and a baby is about to come out from her pregnant womb. She has never ever felt the pain of this. In the pangs of childbirth, what does Allah say to her? Allah tells her, وَهُزِّي إِلَيْكِ بِجِذْعِ النَّخْلَةِ تُسَاقِطْ عَلَيْكِ رُطُبًا جَنِيًّا فَكُلِي وَاشْرَبِي وَقَرِّي عَيْنًا. What did Allah tell Maryam? Allah told Maryam, and grab the bark of the tree and huzzi. Now tell me please, a pregnant woman in the throngs of her delivery, how much strength does she have to move the bark of a tree? How much strength does she have? Nothing. But Allah still told her, grab the bark of a tree and move it. Shake it as much as you can, and the dates will fall down upon you, and you eat the dates. And so sugar at the times of pain and suffering acts as a depressant of your pain. And that is what Allah told her. Never ever think that you are gonna get Allah's help without sabab. Never ever think you're gonna get Allah's help without sabab. Even if you're weak, even if you're weak, even if you're sick, even if you don't have the means, do it. Do it, and the rest is up to Allah. And this is the essence of tawakkul. The essence of tawakkul is preparation. وَعِدُّوا لَهُمْ مَسْتَطَعْتُمْ. Prepare for them whatever you can. مَسْتَطَعْتُمْ, whatever you can. Rest is upon Allah. How do you know you have tawakkul? How do you know you have tawakkul? Number one is that you do things beyond your means. Meaning not that you buy a car beyond your means. No, that's not what I mean. What I mean is you do things for Allah and you do projects that are beyond your means. Okay, you have $5,000 in your account right now, but you say, inshallah, I'm going to do the masjid. The masjid is $5 million. This is sihhatul i'timad ala Allah. wa kufrun bima fi aydi nas. Do you understand? Is that your goals are larger than what you have prepared for. Your goals for the ummah and helping Allah is larger than what you are able to do. Because that is when the heart's attached to Allah. And that is when you say to Allah, O Allah, if you love it, you fund it. I am the faqir, you are the ghani. You fund it, O Allah, I am just the means through which it will happen. But Rabbana, you are the ones who will make it happen. So are you the one who always says, kaif, kaif, kaif? When the Shaykh said, let's do this, what do you say? Kaif ya Shaykh, ma indana fulus, ma indana shay ya Shaykh, kaif la? Wallahi, this is the weakest person. This person should be locked in jail. If I was running Australia, I would lock those people in jail, beat them up, 100 lashes. Anyone who says kaif, the one who says kaif, kaif, what do you mean kaif? Kaif is up to Allah. Don't you know? You leave the how to Allah. Upon you's dua, you have the strongest connection. You are on your team is the one who has everything. If we all got together, all on a plane, and asked Allah for everything that our hearts desire, this would not take away from Allah's dominion except as a needle dipped into an ocean. And this is why the ones who stop projects, the ones who don't do things depending on kaif, 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 those people should be put in a cave. Because you know what? These people have no understanding of how Islam works or how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His miracles work. His miracle works with those people who truly trust Allah and do things bigger than what they can do because they know on their side is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number one, sign of tawakkul is that you focus on things for Allah azawajal that are bigger than sometimes your own preparation is for. And by Allah, I've always done it. I'm looking to build one of the first Islamic universities for mercy mission in Malaysia. I have only $6,000 in my pocket, but I'm gonna build that university one day, inshallah. I'm looking to build a hospital for a mercy mission, but I actually have only less than $3,000 in my pocket. How the hell? Is this guy mad? Yes. This is what tawakkul is. It's a little bit of madness. It's a little bit of madness, but it's not madness. It's the cure to madness. The cure to madness is to know who is on your side. If you have Allah and you're doing it for Allah and you want Allah to accept it, then Allah will make it happen. By Allah, this is the way things work in reality. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes things work. When you are not prepared, you don't have the kaif, Allah has every means. So subhanallah, number one is that you focus on something bigger. Number two, when people leave you, when people abandon you, you are even more happy than when they're with you. When people abandon you and people don't support you and they don't give you, you are even more happy than when people do. Because when people support you, you get this feeling, oh my God, am I depending on Allah and depending on people? It was reported that Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, in the Battle of Qadisiyah, which was a final battle between Muslims and the Persian army. In the Battle of Qadisiyah, Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu replaced Khalid ibn Walid. Replaced Khalid ibn Walid as the leader and he put Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas. Why? When the people said, why Umar are you doing that? Because people were beginning to rely on Khalid rather than on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at this man. Look at this man who understood that Allah is the one who should be relied on, not anything else at all. And it is for this intentionally that he replaced Umar with Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas radiallahu ta'ala anhu as a leader over the greatest battle that would be fought after the battle of Badr. Wallahu ta'ala alam. My brothers and sisters in Islam, Sidq of Tawakkul is known by the fact that you trust Allah more than the money in your own pocket. Sidq of Tawakkul is known by the fact that you trust Allah more than the money in your own pocket. And because you don't trust the money in your own pocket, you're ready to give it away. You're ready to give it away because you know that the money in your pocket is not what's going to buy you lunch. It's Allah that's going to buy you lunch. And so as a result, when the Shaykh asks you, or when the project needs it, or when Allah's deen needs it, you're willing to give it away because you know it's Allah who will look after you. It's Allah who will fund him. That's why the Prophet ﷺ said in the authentic hadith, I don't wish that I have the mountain of Uhud in gold except the nightfall would come and have nothing left. Why? Because he has that much tawakkul that Allah will feed him, Allah will look after him rather than the money in his own pocket. When, ya Muslims, are we going to have this level of tawakkul? When we do, we will be walking giants on this earth. Allah will change continents. Allah will move the land with our feet. We will walk wherever we walk. That stone will touch into gold, will turn into a product for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My brothers and sisters in Islam, when we start having sidq al-tawakkul with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that is the day when we will become giants and we will leave a legacy for this ummah. But you don't have tawakkul, then you're going to attach yourselves to that which destroys itself. Yaqul ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, from the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on this earth, is that anyone who attaches himself to something gets the result of it. So anyone who attaches himself to the dunya, loves the dunya, preserves the dunya, works for the dunya, then his actions will be as long as the dunya exists. And if someone attaches himself to Allah and puts his action to Allah and attaches his work to Allah, then his deeds will continue forever, for as long as Allah will be, and that is forever. So my brothers and sisters in Islam, it is high time that believers become strong. And for that to happen, put your trust on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not on anything else. And prepare and hit the earth with your leg even if you are weak. And shake that tree even if you are not able to. For that is how Allah's help will come down, because of your sidq with Allah, your truthfulness with Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of the strongest of people on this earth, of those people who have the greatest of outcomes, who help Islam the greatest because of our sidq of tawakkul on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alladhina qala lahumun nas innan nas qad jama'u lakum fakhshawhum fazadatuhum imana. Why did the iman go up when they saw the enemies congregating? Because they knew Allah was saying, I am on your side, let people go. And that is why when you start donating to Allah, when you start giving Islam your time and your money, what happens first? The first thing that happens, you start getting poor. You start getting poor. You start getting poor, right? And that's why a man came to the Prophet ﷺ and said, Ya Rasulullah, uhibbuka fillah. Uhibbuka fillah. He said, are you sure? He said, I sure, are you sure? Are you sure? Many times he asked him. He said, yes. He said, anyone who loves me truthfully, then poverty will touch him faster than the wind. No, this is how Allah works. The scholars of Islam, Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah, says, why does poverty or weakness touch the one who starts relying on Allah straight away? Why? Because this is Allah's way, Allah's sunnah. You got to understand how Allah works. First thing Allah does is He clears off all of the systems around you. You have surrounded yourself with things that support you. Your family, your jobs, your status, your power, your wealth and your money. Allah removes all of that. Then when you are free of all sabab, all sort of sabab, then the help of Allah comes down like a whirlwind. And then you are supported. Then you know nothing helped you but Allah. Nothing could have helped you, saved you, but Allah. That is when your iman goes up higher. That is when your tawakkul goes stronger. That is when you go higher. And have you ever noticed that you can jump up higher whilst you don't bend your knees? If I'm standing here, I want to jump up. How do I jump up? I bend my knees. I have to crouch down. I have to lower myself. If I want to go up, I have to go down. And that is the whole point of preparing ourselves. Prepare yourselves. You want to have tawakkul? You want to have it? Know that weakness will touch you first. All of the sabab will leave you. Then Allah's help will come down, and it will come down so strongly that it will leave you wondering, and you will forget those days of pain and suffering, because you will become the strongest people on earth.